Dr. Gus Prinsell once told me that the role of the doctor in Kamakwie is primarily that of a teacher. I really didn't understand that advice until I saw the immensity of the medical task in Sierra Leone. The implications became clear. We must train Sierra Leoneans to share the task with us. Then we must step back and trust them with new responsibility.
Sierra Leone is a beautiful country on the coast of West Africa. The size of South Carolina, Sierra Leone has about 4 million people. Over 70% of her people are in rural areas, where the average person lives by farming with hand tools. The medical needs of Sierra Leone are astounding to us as Americans. In many villages, only about 50% of the children survive to reach age 5. The Wesleyan Church of Sierra Leone was born out of a mission effort which began in 1889. Today, it is a national organization of 117 churches, 6 districts, and 18,000 members.
The medical work has grown right alongside the church. In 1930, Dr. S.I. McMillan moved to Kamakwie, where he built a new mission compound and pioneered the hospital ministry. Mrs. McMillan wrote,
"A person with medicine can always be sure of a crowd in Africa. Medicine and evangelism must go hand in hand."
Since those early days, Kamakwie Wesleyan Hospital has been ministering to the physical and spiritual needs of people. Today, it is an 80-bed facility performing 1,400 surgeries and seeing 50,000 outpatients each year. Both Dr. Prinsell and Dr. McMillan were my family doctors when I was growing up in a Wesleyan parsonage near Houghton, New York. By the time I was 7 years old, God had put in my heart the desire to serve Him by becoming a missionary doctor. That desire continued to grow as I heard missionaries portray the need for medical workers. It remained strong through 7 years of medical training and 4 years of experience. Finally, I was prepared to go to Sierra Leone, 25 years after I first dreamed of that possibility.
One of the first speakers I heard after I became a Christian in high school was a missionary. I remember thinking, that's the life for me. Through college, I gradually came to recognize a clear and definite call to serve God in another culture. Tom and I shared the long road of preparation. We went with our 2 small boys, Christopher and Timothy, to Kamakwie Hospital in 1989. Timothy was not even a year old, and much of my time that first year was spent in caring for the boys. Children often adjust more quickly than their parents, and ours were no exception. They thrived in the tropical climate and the love and openness freely shown by African friends of all ages. In the second half of our term, my responsibilities at the hospital increased as Tom became hospital administrator. I was able to support him by doing the hospital's bookkeeping, correspondence, and a variety of other tasks.
Frankly, I found the medical responsibilities at Kamakwie Wesleyan Hospital overwhelming at times. I struggled to find ways of caring for the crowds without burning out or neglecting my relationship with the Lord. Teaching would be more lasting than simply practicing medicine in a setting where the needs are so great.
There aren't enough training programs in Sierra Leone to keep up with the personnel needs of hospitals and clinics. On-the-job training is essential to the ongoing work at Kamakwie. Missionary schedules are already overloaded. Short-termers can help us solve this problem. Andrea Randall is a lab technician from Battle Creek, Michigan. Under Wesleyan Gospel Corps, she came to Kamakwie for 6 months and taught an intensive training course for laboratory assistants. Simon Samura was trained by Andrea. In spite of demanding hospital duties, Simon is one of several hospital workers who also serves the district as a lay pastor.
When we went to Sierra Leone, I saw an opportunity to provide staff members like Simon with ongoing medical education, challenging them to upgrade their skills. At the same time, I had a burden for the spiritual growth of the 55 Sierra Leoneans on staff. To meet these needs, missionary nurse Heather Weeb and I teamed up to start classes for employees. Every Wednesday afternoon, a medical staff member would teach a medical topic to the nursing assistants. Following that, 3 groups met to study the Bible. What a delight to teach these classes!
Adama Kamara is a registered nurse who came to know Christ through her treatment at Kamakwie Wesleyan Hospital. Years later, the hospital assisted her financially in her training. As a nurse, Autumn returned to Kamakwie to give back to others what God had given her. In a village one day, Autumn learned about a small child who was very sick. In desperation, the child's mother had gone to the medicine man. "Nothing can be done," he told them. "A powerful curse has been placed on the child. She will soon die." When Autumn saw the child having a seizure, she suspected meningitis or severe malaria. The parents agreed to let her take the child back to Kamakwie Hospital. Autumn made sure the child received antibiotics, seizure medicine, and malaria treatment. She prayed for God to touch that little girl. It wasn't long before the child regained full health. Mother and child returned to their village as a living testimony to God's power. Many years earlier, God had touched Adama's life as a small child in the hospital. Now she was touching the lives of others with the love of Christ.
Like Adama, Sam Koba is a registered nurse. He is also a lay pastor overseeing a nearby Wesleyan church. Evenings, when he's not on call, you can find him in the village visiting and teaching. Sam comes from a well-to-do family in Freetown, where he attended the National School of Nursing. There, a roommate led Sam to Christ. It wasn't easy for Sam to relocate to Kamakwie. Sam left home, family, and the conveniences of the city. I'm not sure we missionaries have sacrificed any more than Sam has to work at Kamakwie. Yet he is now in his 8th year of service at the hospital. Sam usually worked late when he was the nurse in charge of the hospital. I didn't understand why he spent so much time with people. But I had something to learn. Sam soon proved to be the best source of information about people in the hospital. He knew the believers and discerned their needs. He could sense when a Muslim patient might be open to the gospel, and when one was deathly afraid his illness was due to witchcraft. Sam's loving concern for people was evident inside and outside of the hospital.
The events of Wednesday, April 29th, 1992, were to change all of our lives. In Kamakwie, we weren't too alarmed. After all, there had been coups before. Our Sierra Leonean friends predicted that everything would be back to normal by the following Monday. But Saturday at 3:30 a.m., we received the message that all Americans were to move quickly to the airport. We packed hurriedly and informed the executive committee that they were in charge.
The burden of running the hospital in the absence of the doctors fell on the shoulders of Sam Koba as chairman of the committee.
After we prayed together, there was no feeling of panic, only a sense of the abiding presence and power of God. The evacuation reminds us that our work in this world is on a deadline, and it's not a deadline we will set.
When I see the lives of Simon, Adama, and Sam, I say, "Thank you, Lord." There are many young people of their caliber and spiritual maturity within the Wesleyan Church of Sierra Leone. Pray for them that they will continue to grow in their commitment to serve Christ. Pray for us as we train Sierra Leoneans and trust them in leadership positions.
We need career missionaries to be teachers and role models.
We need short-term professionals to provide training and assistance to get the job done. Your gifts can make their ministry a reality.
The future is bright for Kamakwie Wesleyan Hospital as we support it with our prayers, gifts, and love.
As we are faithful, God's will can be accomplished in Sierra Leone.